check your choices. It may make God keep quiet on you. Welcome to today's DDRX. We're looking at check your choices. Today we want to look at Abraham and Lot. How God called Abraham out of paganism. You know, he chose to follow God. He chose to obey. He was willing to build an altar for God at all costs. He also had a choice not to take Lot, his nephew, with him. But he brought Lot along. You know what? God kept quiet with that choice for 25 years. Check your choices. It may make God keep quiet on you. God may not advance your instruction beyond your last point of obedience. So this is what happened. After Abraham took Lot with him, the consequences of that choice, you know, the consequences were many. The Bible says there was strife in Genesis 13, 7 to 9. And there was strife between the herdsmen of Abraham's livestock and the herdsmen of Lot's livestock. The Canaanite and the Perizzite then dwell in the land. So Abraham said to Lot, "Please let there be no strife between you and me, and between my herdsmen and your herdsmen, for we are brethren. It's not the whole land before you. Please separate from me. If you take the left, then I will go to the right. Or if you go to the right, then I will go to the left." You know what? Lot chooses an ambition. When Abraham was ready to build an altar, in Genesis 13, the Bible tells us in verse 10, "And Lot lifted his eyes and saw the plain of Jordan, that it was well watered everywhere, before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, like the garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt, as you go towards Zoar." Verse 11, "Then Lot chose for himself all the plain of Jordan, and Lot journeyed east, and they separated from each other." So Lot looked at, you know, the place with his physical eyes, sight and senses. So it's a matter of choice. In Genesis 13, 14 to 18, we saw what happened. The Bible says, "Then Abraham moved his tent and went and dwelt by the terephah trees of Mamre, which are in Hebron, and built an altar there to the Lord." So your choices reveal the world from God's perspective. You know, by giving up the least, Abraham found the most. By taking what seemed to be the most, Lot found the least, because he was carnal with his choices. Your choices affect those who come after you. In Ezekiel 18:2, the Bible says, "What do you mean when you use this proverb concerning the land of Israel, saying, 'The fathers have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are set on edge'?" So your choices can affect even the coming generation. So check your choices. Thank you.